Obama's favorite congresswoman going to prison for disgusting thing she did to kids while on the job. Corruption goes with politics like peanut butter goes with jelly. It's not that they have to go together, it's just that people always seem to put them together. It's an almost universal truth that when you get a group of powerful people together, a few of them will have let that power go to their heads and done some pretty shady stuff. There are some serious gray areas when it comes to Congress people and the leverage that they can have over their constituents. Sometimes things get blurry and a person finds themselves on the wrong side of an investigation, almost before they know it. But that's not what we're here to talk about today. Today, we're reporting on one of the DNC's shining stars, and one of the first black women to be elected to her position who was caught with her hand in some children's cookie jar. Democratic Representative Corrine Brown of Florida has been sentenced to prison for running a sham charity that was supposed to funnel the donations to go toward furthering education. As it turns out, they just funneled the money right into Brown's pocket, funding everything from vacations to general merriment, as the congresswoman saw fit. According to Fox News, she will be getting 5 years in prison for her crimes. Former Florida Democratic Representative Corrine Brown was sentenced on Monday to 5 years in prison for mail, wire and tax fraud involving a sham charity. A jury convicted Brown of stealing money from a bogus charity, One Door for Education, which purported to give scholarships to poor children but instead filled the coffers of Brown and her associates. Federal prosecutors said she and a top aide committed fraud by using donations for lavish parties and trips. The aide and another official later accepted a plea deal and testified against Brown, who served in Congress for nearly 25 years. She was defeated in her 2016 primary race. Earlier this year, One Door President Carla Wiley pleaded guilty to one count of conspiracy to commit wire fraud after it was determined that she had deposited $800,000 into the foundation's account over 4 years. Over that time, federal prosecutors say it gave one scholarship for $1,000 and that Wiley transferred herself tens of thousands of dollars. Brown's former chief of staff, Elias Ronnie Simmons, and the charity's president pleaded guilty after their federal indictments for misusing the charity's funds, and testified against Brown. Brown testified that she was left in the dark about the goings-on with One Door's money, and blamed the theft on Simmons. She was convicted in May on 18 of 22 charges. Brown's attorney was seeking probation in Monday's sentencing. There are a lot of slimy things that a person can do with their lives, but stealing money donated for children is right up there with some of the slimiest. It doesn't even appear that there was any pretense of an attempt to do the right thing, she just used the money for herself and that was that. So much for going to Washington to watch her people's backs or acting like she was a real live public servant. While she will no doubt get out long before the 5 years are up, and someone will make a martyr of her because she is female, and a minority, but I remind you that if minorities and feminists want to be treated as equal, they need to take that equal in every form. This is a crime, cut and dried, and it deserves prison time. If she didn't want to go to prison, she shouldn't have stolen money. Tampa Bay Times, the local news outlet that covered the story, has more details about the congresswoman and her career in politics. Brown, 71, was ordered to turn herself into authorities no earlier than January 8. She represented a Florida district that included Jacksonville during her nearly 25-year career. Brown, a Democrat who was one of the first three African Americans to be elected to Congress from Florida since Reconstruction, was convicted by a federal jury in May on 18 of the 22 charges against her, which included fraud, lying on her tax returns and on her congressional financial disclosures. Prosecutors outlined a pattern of fraud by Brown and her top aide that included using hundreds of thousands of dollars from the One Door for Education Foundation for lavish parties, trips, and shopping excursions. Brown's former chief of staff, Elias Ronnie Simmons, and One Door's executive director Carla Wiley had accepted plea deals and testified against Brown. They were also sentenced Monday. Simmons was sentenced to 4 years in prison, followed by 3 years of probation, and Wiley received a 1-year sentence following by 3 years of probation. They too were ordered to turn themselves in no earlier than January 8. Federal prosecutors said the three used one door to bring in more than $800,000 between 2012 and 2016, including a high-profile golf tournament at TPC Sawgrass. The Virginia-based One Door only gave out one scholarship for $1,200 to an unidentified person in Florida, according to court documents. Simmons told jurors that his boss ordered him to take cash and checks from One Door's account on dozens of occasions and deposit the money into Brown's personal account. Brown testified in her own defense, saying she was left in the dark about the details of One Door's money and blamed the theft on Simmons. Her attorneys argued for leniency at a hearing last month, saying Brown's community work should mitigate her crimes.